We can stand up here and scream and cry and complain and curse and so on and so forth about the need for more resources. The request formally needs to come from the executive branch. That request needs to come from the executive branch. The governor, the superintendent of the state police, is not going to listen to the Baltimore City Council. They're not going to. That request must formally come from the executive branch. And that's what we are asking as part of, as one of the components of that crime plan.
Wow, after 8 years, we see
it's finally happened,
an outraged City Council of Baltimore standing at the podium, six strong, 14 of them, 15 if you include the president of the City Council, saying that, look, get to the governor, get to the state police, ask for help. And they didn't even say Mayor Brandon Scott's name. They said the executive branch. Like, they were making it real sterile. Like, we want the executive branch. That's what they were talking about the mayor, to go to the governor and the mayor, because he said, the governor's not going to listen to us. He's going to listen to you. You've been meeting with him. It was a very, very different tone yesterday, Bryan, from the committee, by the way. And we're going to be joined, everyone, after the 8:30 news by Baltimore City Councilman Eric Costello. That's the committee, the Ways and Means Committee of the City Council, that has say over the budget of the police department. And those committee members were standing yesterday. So what they're in essence doing, Bryan, and 5:30 Club, is threatening the budget. That's what they're doing, standing there saying, if you guys don't do it, I'm a good. They're not only asking about the police department, they want staffing of the state's attorney's office. They want, you know, all these different things. They're going to try to use the purse strings to leverage.
I don't know if we say the gloves are finally off.
Sounds like
or
it.
At least there's a sparring, you know, match going on between the city council and the mayor. It is unfathomable it took this long to get to the
years.
Point that we're at now. Seeing how terrible, especially it's been this year, and the fact that the crime plan has not been working, and everybody knows it hasn't been working. But we do finally at least have a push from members of the city council to say more has to be done, Mr. Mayor.
The mayor responded, not in a presser or anything, but in a statement.
Well, he's not happy. It's pretty clear to me.
I would only ask, I'm going to just read this one line. I would only ask them, he didn't even say names, I would only ask them to stay engaged in this critical work and match my urgency and effort in bringing real change for our residents. Mr. Mayor, the only problem with that statement is the city council is saying, you're not urgent.
Right.
He's saying the reason we've had this press conference, the reason they held that press conference yesterday is because, yeah, we like that group violence reduction thing. They said that might be okay. And by the way, we'll get to this Muncie and Shantae Jackson, who, by the way, tentatively, she's going to be on next week to talk about some of this. But anyway, bottom line, Bryan, is they're saying, where's the immediate? Where is the now? Sounds like something we've been saying for a while.
Absolutely. And, you know, beyond comprehension is how they describe the violence that's going on right now. You also heard them talk about all of the phone calls that they receive on a regular basis from constituents about how something needs to be done. So the voices are starting to finally have an impact.
Boy,
on
that
sure
took a long time
council.
To boil, didn't it? That water took a long time to boil up.
It did. I'm not sure why it took so long, but we are to the point now where, all right, now we're getting somewhere, at least when it comes to urgency and demand to do something. I'm not sure why they didn't mention the mayor's name. I can't quite figure that out.
It sounded to me like what they were trying to do, and this is more political than anything else, it sound as if we're not him. Like, they didn't say us, they didn't say we, the executive. When you say the executive branch or the exec, you're trying to say that over there is what parlance kind of politically that is. Like a distancing.
I know, but it feels, again, just like when the mayor or the police commissioner won't talk about won't mention Mosby.
Yeah,
right?
but this is different.
Why wouldn't you mention the mayor's name? Why wouldn't you say the mayor? The mayor's in charge of these things. The mayor hires and fires the police commissioner. The mayor talks to the,
but
to
this
the
is different,
governor
Bryan.
On a regular basis.
They won't even say the state's attorney's office. They won't even say the prosecutor. All they say is the justice system. They don't even singular it. At least the city council made it singular. They didn't say the police commissioner. They didn't say. They said the executive branch. Now, the letter is to the police commissioner,
right,
but the statement from the podium was to the mayor.
I know, but can you explain to me why that is? I mean, what's the point of not using the mayor's name or just, you know, addressing it directly to
Mr.
Scott?
Because they're making it business. This is not, they all know each other. They serve together. Most of them served with Brandon when he was councilman.
Sure.
What they're trying to do is not make it my friend Brandon. They're saying the executive, which means we're business today. This isn't wow. you, my buddy. I know. It doesn't. I'm just telling you, politics is nuanced. It just is, because they all know each other. And if he were to say, I wish Brandon would do such and such, it wouldn't be taken as seriously as the executive needs to do thus and so. Now, the other part of this, everybody, they gave a date. They want this done by June the 3rd.
Mm-hmm.
Because June the 3rd is when the committee meets to go over the budget. So I like it when there are definites. You know, and I want to know, and we'll ask the councilman about this, what if they don't have it June the 3rd?
That's right. What happens?
What happens?
Or will they hold up the money?
Yeah.
And then, you know, and that is a real threat. I assume that the mayor takes that seriously. His response last night, his statement, as you mentioned, part of it, the Eric Costello said he believed that the mayor would ultimately adhere to their desires.
Well, with the state's attorney. Because once again, this is not just a demand of the mayor and the police department, even though they want the governor to weigh in. What I understand, what I'm hearing through the grapevine, the governor's office may have a statement coming very shortly, even though they told the mayor to get to the governor. But what about state's attorney? They want staffing of the state's attorney's office numbers. They want a lot of stuff related to how many prosecutors are needed to do whatever.
Do you remember when that was racist to ask if
yes.
for an audit of the state's attorney's
white
office?
White supremacy.
Remember when
the governor's coming after a black woman. Coming after a black woman.
That's right.
That's what she said. I didn't say that.
But
she
now the city council made up of a majority.
Wait a minute. Costello's
majority
white.
No, he's white.
There you go.
Of course, they put him out there front and center to do all of these
but
things.
Others did speak. You had Sharon Middleton that spoke, the councilman.
Well, Sharon Middleton was, she said people are calling our offices crying out for help.
Yep.
We need to do something now. Absolutely, and of course that's been going
Robert
on for
Stokes,
years now.
Robert Stokes spoke, and we talked about him yesterday, asking for the state police to come in. Your question to me, and everybody, I will give my co-host credit. I've been, and as well as some others, saying National Guard. You've been saying state police,
yep.
asking the governor about state police, asking Commissioner Michael Harrison about state police. I know they don't have a lot of them. I know they don't. I know numerically the state police, I think, are somewhere around 2,000. So not even as many state police as there are Baltimore City police officers. But what about a crisis? Right now, the crisis is not Cecil County,
mm-hmm.
I know they staff Cecil County.
Yeah.
The crisis is not Dorchester. I know they staff Dorchester.
Right.
The crisis is here.
It is.
It's here. So why not just give a few? You can part with like 50, right? Maybe?
I would think
75?
You would be able to. I mean, that's been what I've been saying for a long time. Put state troopers on the street. I don't want them. That's fine that they can, you know, patrol 83 and do all some other things that Baltimore
right.
City
Nobody
police doesn't
sees
have to.
Them there, though.
But put them on the actual streets.
Yes.
For at least the summertime in Baltimore City.
90 days.
And you don't have to take them from Western Maryland or the Eastern Shore.
Right.
You can take them right from the
Pikesville.
Middle part of,
yeah,
of the
Pikesville
state.
Barracks.
Take them from Anne Arundel, Baltimore, yeah. Howard County, that area in the middle part of the state, and put them on the streets of Baltimore.
This action yesterday, everybody, of these six council members. I had to replay. Just play it one more time. Play that one more time, Kevin.
We can stand up here and scream and cry and complain and curse and so on and so forth about the need for more resources. The request formally needs to come from the executive branch. That request needs to come from the executive branch. The governor, the superintendent of the state police, is not going to listen to the Baltimore City Council. They're not going to. That request must formally come from the executive branch. And that's what we are asking as one of the components of that crime plan.
That, Brian, is saying this is not personal, Brandon, which they all call him Brandon.
Mm-hmm.
That's why they say executive branch. We need something done. That's what that took away.
Okay, that's fine. I think that's fair. But the city council could have been talking about this for years, right? There's nothing that would
have stopped
them from
doing it. How about the summer of 2015 when we knew the craziness was going on right after the National Guard left in 2015?
Right. So, I mean, the timing of it is, I would assume, is that they're preparing themselves for a summer surge of violence.
I think, Brian, we've talked about it since last year. The murder of Officer Holly, the murder of Evelyn Player, the murder of a grandmother, DoorDash driver, the murder of the husband of a police lieutenant, the murder of a 13-year-old girl on a playground. I could keep going. I think the accumulation of all of that, and in the last week, you know, the murder of a pregnant woman, they mentioned that from the podium, all of that finally has overwhelmed them.
Maybe so. Maybe so. Maybe this is progress.